is in this, we will see the fragmentation which occurs due to the variable partition method. So here what happens, the first fit and best fit, the previous one what we have seen, it suffer from external fragmentation. So there are fragmentation means memory is splitted then and there. So that is why it is called fragment. The memory is fragmented. So we will see what is that. There are two types of fragmentation. One is internal fragmentation and another one is external fragmentation. So here we will see, first we will see what is external fragmentation. As processes are loaded and removed from memory, the free memory space is broken into little pieces. So for example, here this is a memory available. Now what happens here, 15K memory here, once the processor added, what happened here, some 20K is there, then 40K. These are all the process. The one which are in the yellow color represent the process. This is the operating system space. So here this is a free space. Here say some 5K is available. Here some 10K is available. Let us imagine. So what happens? Here let us say this is 10K, this is some 5K, this is some 15K. These are all the free spaces and these are all the process occupied. So now what happens? Here some space is there, here some space is there, here some space is there. Let us consider a new process is arriving which needs nearly some 20K. But we are not able to allocate one full partition because 15K is available here, 5K is available here, and 10K is available there. Now if we add all these things, then what happens? 10 here, 15 plus 5, 20. 20 plus 10, 30K is there. Some free space is there. But still, we are not able to assign a 20K. The process which is coming now, it requests 20K space. But even if we have 30K space available, we are not able to allocate because that memory is splitted. Our process requires continuous allocation. That is why the name, the scheme of this memory management is called as continuous allocation. So your process, if a process gets in, it requires a continuous space. You cannot split 15K here, the 20K process. You cannot split the 20K spaces, 20K process into 15K here and 10K here and so on. It is not possible. It needs a continuous 20K space. So that is a problem. So here external fragmentation, the space is there, but still we are not able to assign the space for incoming process. So total memory space exists to satisfy a request, but it's not contiguous. Storage is fragmented into a large number of small holes. So how it can be removed? By adding, compacting, by combining. So how it can be combined? Move this process up, then move this process up, move these holes down. So 15K, this 5K, 10K, everything comes down. All this process goes up so that the 30K is combined together. This space is combined together and made as one big hole. But the problem is the movement of this process will disturb the relocation register, base register, everything. And again, the user has to compile his program. All those things are that the space has, this user process has to be compiled and executed again because the memory is changed. It has been moved up. So in that case, these problems comes across. But anyway, we will see the next one, internal fragmentation. Here, suppose I want to a process which is coming 10K. Okay, 10K is coming. This space is available. Now 10K is space. The remaining 5K is. This is a 15K partition, but 10K is allocated. 5K is remaining there. So what will happen to that? So like this, if the memory occurs, then that is called internal fragmentation. That is, in a partition, you will be able to give the space, but the remaining space. So for example, 20K means here 20, here 10K means whether in here it is here we have given is 10, 15K as this memory space. Now I'm the incoming process is 12K. Imagine this 12K will be. It can be placed here, but what happened? The 3K, the remaining 3K will be wasted. It cannot be allocated to some other process also. So this is what called internal fragmentation. Allocated memory may be